And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. These starting sequences take a long time to load. So we're in the Endless Paths of Adnua, level 1. Over here is some magical kind of portal, something like that. But I don't want to go through that until I've explored the rest of this area, so I suppose we'll go... Didn't we check out this room already? Hold on a second. No, we can't, can we? Hold on a second.
No problem.
Go around the corner here, see what's over here. Ah, we can get in this way. We've already checked out that thing. I'm assuming this is on this side. Okay. Anyway, we could move it to there. Yep, I knew it. Alright, so... We've been fighting with our fair assortment of spiders in this episode, and we're apparently not done yet. He has his bow, right? Okay. So this is an ivory spinner.
Yeah.
Well, this will take some of the fight off before it even moves. I like this. A unified line. Pretty cool. Oops. Ivory spinner binding web. Though I do like to protect the wizard. Oh, but he's stuck. All he managed in doing is moving up closer. That's no good. He's not stuck, though. I guess he just can't get past them. Well, it could get rather rough for Aloth at the moment. Two of our sort of fighter types are stuck, so. Some holy radiance. Oh, he's all the way up here, so. Finish that one off. Let's see if Aloth can get off a magic missile or minor missile, whatever you like to call it. Oh no, I didn't want to use mind wave necessarily. Actually, well, where is she? No, not yet. Amplified thrust off of Eater. That was a little useless. Nothing? We can't loot these? Oh. Oh my god. Oh my god. We should have... We should have snuck. We're not gonna get off arrows in time, are we? I mean, I assume that everything else was aware of us being here from the fight, right? So let's just stay in. So let's just stay in this melee. Get rid of this queen. She's gonna kill at least one of us. I know it. I'm not gonna have the cleric go yet, because I want to get us all with this, with his holy radiance thing. So rather, I would just try to move him in the middle, so maybe he can get us all. So we got this one, this spear spider leading the charge, so let's redirect here. And since we know we're going to be centered right around here, let's go with Holy Radiance. Necrotic Lance of the Spider Queen. Oh boy. And we already used the Amplified Thrust up, so let's do a Soul Shock off of Eater. Actually, off of Firebrand this time. Ouch. It can attack from back here, that's not good. And let's get rid of this thing. He's still yet to go. Okay. How about a shield on... Well, it can actually hit all of us. It's coming around, look at that. Okay, our next trick will be Restore Light Endurance. Oh, I'm gonna make sure we hit all of them. I hope we're hitting all of them. I can't see. Necrotic again on the Spider Queen. And, at this point, we killed this, right? So let's finish off the Spiderling. Be really quick, and then we can just focus on the spider. That's what we'll do. Okay, now we can get this thing. Out. Arcane Assault. He still has yet to cast his spell. Durance, that is. And, what's her name? Theodess needs to get back some focus by hitting this thing. Okay. Alright. We can be okay with this. Gaunt's Pledge, yeah. Oh my god, that was quick. She's out, isn't she? It's just too late. He still has yet to use this arcane thing. Wait, did he just do it? Okay. One more. Theodess is down! Another healing for our warriors.
get.
Oish. Wow. That was a tough queenie. What are these things holding them? Ooh. Oidrecht. Oh, look at that. A spider venom sac. The mottled venom gland of a spider bulging with deadly fluids. No kidding. That was rather rough. Oidrecht. Oidrecht? I'm gonna say it Oidrecht. Once belonged to a prominent military instructor in the capital city of Adir. The instructor was a cipher whose gifts were seldom used by his empire, and he grew frustrated at his superior's inability to see the potential of ciphers to perform key missions that no other force would be capable of. He began making his opinion known, and over time the opinion became more subversive and radical, until at last his unsanctioned activities got him charged with treason. The officer and crew that came to detain him, however, underestimated him as much as the Empire had, and with only this blade and the talents of his mind, he slew his would-be captors. He fled the city and embarked on a life as a duelist, obsessed with proving his potential to any who would question it. In the end, his life ended in the manner that the lives of duelists typically do, and the potential he often spoke of would remain just that. The knife still bears his psychic imprint, and the wielder will often get flashes of the maneuvers the original owner performed in order to deliver the killing blow to his opponent. Huh. Some regard this as a curse, but many find value in it, and use such experiences to better realize the knife's potential. Were it not for the evidence of heavy use about the handle and pommel, Oidrecht would seem new, its cutting edge perfectly beveled and honed without a single nick along its length. Three damage reduction bypass. 20% of damage restored is endurance. Damaging plus one. Damaging one plus 15% damage. Nice. Can we compare? It won't let me compare, really. I guess they're two different things. 13 to 18 slash pierce. What is she using now? 12 to 17 crush. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Friggin' Facebook app. 12 to 17 crush. There we go. I started doing a comparison, I don't know why. After not doing it. So we just gotta find hatchet. One's slashing, one's piercing, but this one's... What do you think? You think we should give it to Eater? A stiletto. 12 to 17 pierce, which isn't as much as the damage there, but it is a fast weapon as opposed to average. Plus it's got all these neat things. Nice. We'll try that out on our eater here. I'm tending to think of him as the main fighter now because he's the highest level.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna have to head back soon and get more camping supplies.
Hmm.
Which stinks. We go up these stairs?
Yeah.
We do? Oh. Oh. All right. Let's put that in there. Weathered and covered with a dull patina. I guess that's how you say that. This elaborately carved pillar appears far older than the surrounding structure. Ooh, moonstones. Moonstone derives its name from its moonlight-like luster and is sometimes collected by Andra's gift bearers who associate the stone's presence in the world with the legends of Andra's love affair with the moon. Obviously, we're going to take both. Padded armor. And 177 copper pans.
Problem.
I have to go all the way back and leave at this point. We really have to.
Hey.
I don't know. Think a little bit more? Maybe a little bit more.
Eh?
Just save just in case. See what's up here.
Quickly and quietly.
Hmm. Oh, wow. What's this all about? We can walk on that? Oh. That's a quite unusual area. Just looking around for secrets or anything? Looks pretty. I don't know. What are we walking on? Some kind of marble or something. A little ladder. Oh. Alright, we found a little way out. Okay. Oh, okay. Cool. That was locked, wasn't it? It took an hour.
Eh?
There's something here, look at that. Is there a secret door, maybe?
I'll see what I can find.
We will all see what we can find. No, I don't know. Okay, we got some more places we haven't explored up here and then in this room. Or in most of the room? There's another way in as well. I don't know why some of that shadowed out there. Fog of war type stuff. I think I'll just run. And so far we haven't seen wandering monsters in this game. Wouldn't put it past them to change everything, but...
I shall be quiet as a calm sea.
Which isn't much.
Which is not very quiet.
Mm-hmm. Especially when your voice booms out like that, guy. Who dat? A looter. Hello, looter. Meet our arrows. Unless you're with a disadvantage because... Yeah. Our priest has one spell, and our wizard is completely out. That's why I want to go back and get healing, I mean, camping supplies, but I was hoping maybe we'd find some. I haven't found any for quite a while. Quite a while.
Eh?
There's another. I think we got trouble. Let's get this guy in front. Once these guys start moving in, Aeloth can get them with an arcane assault. Let's get us with Holy Radiance. Amplified Thrust off of Aether. As you know, I love doing. And that's it.
Yeah.
Is that a mage back there? This is not going well. Did our priest go yet? We can get all three of them like this. Still has yet to go. It's so a shame. Okay. Restore light endurance. Still has yet to do her amplified thrust. Arcane assault is very quick, so that was already done. Okay. He's out. Well, since he's out, might as well wade into battle here. We can take out this looter. Or help. He lost too. And Soul Shock off of Canna this time. Oh, there's another one back here. He is attacking a lot quicker with that stiletto. He's not doing a lot of damage though. Eater. It's grazing him. He keeps grazing him. She's starting to get some of her focus back. Make short work of him and get that archer. Hello. We're gonna kill you. Yeah. A hood? A nasal helm. It says with the nose guard. Gold rat shoe and lockpicks. And a padded cap. Alright. Oh, and there's someone up there too. A frog helm. And some copper.
Sure.
Let's look for secrets.
And what does the flame reveal?
Maybe nothing much. Oh, we found something.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Oh.
No. Keep away from us. Leave us.